Traveled a rocky road to get back into title contention. Here's Ed Robinson.
Jason Cook's had a tough journey to the Lonsdale belt.
Yeah, I think the last 17 years have been up and down really, Ed, but, you know, this is what I really trained for. You know, I turned pro in 96, really for the British title.
Following a prison sentence for fraud, Cook turned his life around, capturing the European lightweight title at late notice in Italy with a shock knockout, only to then lose the belt on the scales.
Stupidity on my own part. I should have pulled out 6 weeks beforehand when I injured my foot, but I went through with the fight because we sold it out within 48 hours.
Injuries forced the Welsh puncher into retirement. Returning after a four-year break, he lost out to prize fighter winner Gavin Rees, but now challenges Lenny Daws.
He's a great fighter, but I've been through a lot more in my life than what Lenny Daws is going to bring.
He is dangerous. He's dangerous with both hands, left and right hands, you know, so we've been working on things in the gym, so I'm prepared to do whatever it takes to get the win on him, yeah.
In sharp contrast to Cook, Daws is known for his consistency. Always fit, determined and relentless.
They always have to throw new sparring partners in with me. They call me the machine at the gym because, as you say, I've got such a great engine.
The champion's also on a high, having avenged his only defeat by knocking out Barry Morrison.
Lenny Daws is the British light welterweight champion all over again.
Daws has never been stopped, but Cook's ready to turn up the heat.
We're both going to be firing away in there.
There's not going to be a backup step from any one of us, I don't think, but I just think I bring more power.
Both desperately want this. It should be an exciting fight, Johnny.
It should be very exciting. Daws, an unbelievable engine. It pace is king for him, and he knows that. For a man at 31 years old to work at such a high tempo and be so calm with it as well and controlled with it, very, very good.
Is work rate the key then for you?
It's got to be for Daws. He's got to make sure he keeps Cook at arm's length, keep him chasing around the ring, keep him guessing, keep him on the back foot, and just keep it. Don't let him get comfortable.
He showed that great engine, that great work rate in his last fight when he overpowered Barry Morrison. It was a good night for him.
Barry Morrison, the only man to inflict a defeat on Daws' record, and what he did was he went back to the drawing board, knew exactly how to deal with him, worked off the jab, used the ring, worked on the outside, quick flews on the inside. When he was under pressure, took tight, turned him, and he knew how to deal with Morrison, and even went up close, pumped the shots out. Couldn't deal with him.
He's never in a bad fight, is he?
Never in a bad fight because he's consistently working. If you're sat watching, you think, is this man going to run out of steam? Never does. It's usually his opponent.
How do you counteract this work rate?
Don't be predictable. Cook has to not just go for that big shot, which I have a funny feeling that's what he's going to try and do and think, I've got the power to sort this man out. He's got to not be predictable, put him under pressure, cut the ring off, counter it.
What about Jason Cook then? Inactivity, 10 rounds in the last 4 years. Could be fresh though, could he?
Yeah, the time off could have given him hunger. The time off could have given him a new insight into the fight. The time off could have given him a new desire. And he thinks he can win this.
And of course, the last thing to go, they say, as a fighter is your knockout power. He has certainly got that.
That's right, and this man is dangerous.
Okay, hope you enjoy our coverage in high definition with up to five times the picture quality here on Sky Sports HD 1. They're looking forward to it. You can also catch the action in standard definition on Sky Sports 1. Your commentators, Adam Smith and Glenn McCrory, after our MC, John McDonald.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment you've all been waiting for. This is the main event, the fight of the night. Please welcome to the ring now from Maesteg, Wales, Jason Cook.
Tremendous atmosphere in the home of British boxing. Well, there have been many comeback attempts over the years, most end fairly swiftly, and to be honest, quite comprehensively, but there are success stories, especially if timeout and inactivity have been much-needed refresheners. Jason Cook retired after a good career, but he's matured, he's reflected, and he feels he still has the skills to mix it at least domestic level. The former European champion at lightweight, an explosive puncher in his prime. He's drilled himself into shape to give him the best of chances.
Yeah, certainly do, and he's never done it the easy way. Had some very, very good wins, and I think the rest done him good. He's rejuvenated, got that power, and I think this is going to be a good fight.
got a tough ask, because Lenny Daws is a champion and he's a very, very hard man to overcome.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, time to welcome the champion, Lenny Daws.
Plenty of the Morden Massive out in force. There's the British title, the coveted Lonsdale belt for the popular light welterweight champion, beginning his second reign, the uncomplicated and underrated Lenny Daws. They love him, the fans. He's energetic, he's fit, he's capable, and he's a favourite South London way because of his desire, drive and non-stop action. He knows he's not a world beater, Glenn, but he's tough to beat and he's a bit of a throwback.
Yeah, what you see is what you get with Lenny Daws. He comes in, he works hard, takes the fight to whoever. And, you know, he's got some good names on his record. People like Colin Lyons, Nigel Wright, Barry Morrison, quality names.
Only defeat to Barry Morrison, but he gained revenge here last year, becoming the only man to stop the Scot. Will he stop Jason Cook tonight? It really is a fascinating one. Cook older, 35 in a couple of weeks. The height and reach advantages to Daws. Cook, will he be struggling to make that 10 stone limit these days? 9.13.6 just inside. Well, he's been around forever, Cook, but he did have that break. Only a few more fights, more rounds, interestingly, to Daws because of Cook's power. He can bang. 6-1 on Daws. The bookies don't often get it wrong, but plenty of people here fancy the upset. Cook, maybe by knockout. Don't blink with this one.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event, the fight of the night. Barry Hearn from Matchroom Sport, the home of the Prize Fighter Series, proudly presents 12 rounds of boxing for the British Light Waterweight Championship and the coveted Lord Lonsdale's Challenge Belt. Sponsored here by PartyCasino.com, we are live and exclusive on Sky Sports HD. This is Friday Fight Night. All the officials appointed by the British Boxing Board of Control, steward in charge, Mr. Charlie Giles, our area representative, Mr. Des Rees, inspectors Bob Longhurst, Dave Porter, Harold Adams, Jeff Barnett, medical officers at ringside, Dr. Denzel, Fern and O'Callaghan. Our three scoring judges at ringside, Mark Green of Romford, Victor Loughlin of Paisley, Scotland, and Mr. Terry O'Connor of Birmingham. Timekeeper at the bell is Mr. Ray Rice, and when the action begins, the referee in charge from Woodlesford, Leeds, is Mr. Dave Paris. They are the officials, and here are the contestants. Introducing to you, firstly, the challenger. He's fighting out of the blue corner wearing the red trunks, green with green and white, weighing in at 9 stone, 13 pounds, 6 ounces, a 29 fight record, 26 wins, 13 inside the scheduled distance, and just 3 defeats. Here's the former European lightweight champion, the pride of the valleys, from Maesteg, Jason. Ladies and gentlemen, the champion. He's fighting under the red corner wearing the gold trunks trimmed with black, weighing at 9 stone, 13 pounds, 2 ounces, a 22 fight record, 20 wins, 8 inside the scheduled distance, 1 loss, 1 draw, making his first defense in his second reign. He is the holder of the coveted Lord Lonsdale's Challenge Belt. He is the British Light Waterweight Champion and the pride of Morden, the champion, Lenny Lightning Daws. So let's get the action underway in 12 rounds of boxing for the British Light-Welterweight Championship and the coveted Lord Lonsdale's challenge belt.
Boys, you know what to do. Keep your punches on target and remember to defend yourself at all times. Shake hands, good luck to you both.
Big boxing weekend for the capital. And this domestic tussle for the Light-Welterweight Lonsdale belt is one of the most interesting matches that have been made. Styles might really gel here, the tall rangy Daws with the excellent work rate and engine. In with the old Welsh banger, Jason Cook, who's so desperate to get his hands on the British belt, a title he missed out in the main part of his career. Former European champion, but at lightweight. This at 10 stone. Should be good, Glenn.
It should be exciting, it could be dramatic. You've got a very hard work with there, and you've got a big puncher. So we're expecting something to happen. Pretty exciting.
Daws can start slowly. He's been on the canvas a couple of times in the first round. Cook says he's more of a boxer these days. But he flattened Scott Jordan in his comeback fight with the left hook he favours. And that was what took him to the European title out in Italy. 11-1 against that night he was. And a big outsider here. He says, write me off at your peril.
Daws is just trying to settle, hands held high as they should be. Get that jab going.
Trying to get inside. Might have more speed than Daws thinks as well. Got a proper nutritionist on board now, training better, he says, at 34 than he did in his 20s.
Jason Cook has plenty of experience. European champion before.
Look at left hand from Cook. A minute left in the opening round. And here are the big bombs from Jason Cook. Daws nearly went.
That was a very good left hook, but he took it well. I mark that he's got a good chin, but can't afford to get hit there.
As we thought, Cook dangerous early.
The thing is, Adam, Cook's dangerous at all times, right the way through a fight.
Trying the uppercut as well. Just feels he's at a different level, different league to Lenny Daws. Jason Cook, positive start from the Welshman. And trying to load up with that left hand again. Daws survives the early scare.
Alright, okay. Yeah, just that left up. You've got to keep the right hand up. What? Keep the right hand up. Keep moving to your left, alright? Relax a little bit, but glove nice and high. So when he comes back with that left up, you're blocking it. If you force out a jab, a slow jab, he's coming over the top, alright? Okay?
The just experienced mistake, and calm man. Voice of Robert McCracken.
There it is. He just moved his right hand, which he's been holding high throughout the round. He just moved it forward a little bit. Cook let it go, and it got through the gap. Could have been a costly mistake there. But he took the punch well. He wobbled a little bit, but he regrouped very well.
Got a jab, right hand movement, gloves on, uppercut inside and then side to side. Box him, OK, behind that jab. Don't put slow punches out, all right? Come on.
The gold of Lenny Daws, the 31-year-old defending his British light welterweight title. And the Welsh colours of Maestex Jason Cook, very popular figure in the game. He's got plenty of fans here tonight who've come from Wales and also who live here in London. Daws has brought his army from Morden. Two good guys, two good fighters. Robert McCracken wants to see the jab from Daws that took him to the success in the amateurs.
Yeah, he's got to try and control the centre of the ring and use a very controlled jab. Bring it right back. Cook hasn't got to show that left hook too much. Everybody knows he can land with it. He's got to try and suck the Daws into a left hook.
Disguise it using the old tricks. Daws saw that one coming and blocked it. There's blood, I think, around the nose area of Lenny Daws, who's been marked and cut up before.
I think it's a little cut on the left cheek of Daws.
Yep. Head clash caused that. It's in a real danger area. Cook looking for body shots, good right hand back from Daws.
Daws showing good concentration, he's getting that hand into place to block the left hook. But Cook looks dangerous, looks fast.
Yeah, there's the speed from Cook. And the left hand again.
Daws just missing with the right, just rushing in a little bit.
This often takes time to get going, get flowing, Lenny Daws. The cut worsens a bit around the cheek. Robert McCracken always says he'd have been a great 15-round fighter, Daws. It's Cook's a bright start from Cook.
Yep, throwing a lot of punches, isn't he? Some good work from Cook. Nice and sharp and good punches going in.
Will he be able to sustain it, though, through the 12 rounds? That's a big question mark. Good jab, though, from Cook. Looks very sprightly, doesn't he?
Doesn't he? Just good jabs, good hooks, nice movement. Good two rounds for Jason Cook.
Steve switched on for 3 minutes.
Darren Wilson now in the Cook corner, used to be with Brian Evans.
See his elbow still coming up,
and the cut just coming in a little bit low as he does, chin down, looking to way up for the left hook. That time Lenny Daws had it covered.
This the round that saw Jason Cook shoot to European champion out in Italy against Sandro Casamonica. He was down that night, but what a left hook to flatten Casamonica. And it's been a great start here. And have a look at those odds now. 7-4 on from 6-1 on Daws. Cook 5-4 against. Couldn't have asked for a better beginning. And Daws now knows he's got a really tough defense on the cards.
Well, he's an educated boxing from Cook. He said he's changed his style a little bit, become a bit more of a boxer, and that's what he's going to do. He's doing it well, avoiding punches and coming back quickly with his arm.
Yep, retired because of shoulder problems, tendonitis in the ankle as well. Just couldn't get his body going anymore, but he's rested up. And he missed the game so much, Jason Cook. Good to have him back. Nice right from Daws. And a good uppercut. Just needs to steady himself and try and assert control behind that jab.
Yeah, he's got to get a bit busy with the straight punches. He's sparing with the right hand early because that's where he can leave himself open. But needs to be busy with the jab.
Cook body too. Cook made 10-2 for prize fighter, but bringing himself down to 10 stone. He's a lot heavier during his inactivity. There's the right hand from Cook. Really good action, Dan.
Excellent fight so far, isn't he? The door's starting to warm up a little bit more in this round. He's having more success.
That's what he tends to do. You heard in Ed Robinson's report about his gym mates calling him the machine. That engine just keeps on going, and a right hand as well. Better from Daws.
Yeah, getting a foothold in the fight now. More of what we're used to from Lenny Daws.
Yep, the younger man, the fresher man, and the more active man, Daws. Paris just sorts them out, but that was better from the Londoner.
I don't want to be hooks, all right?
Welcome back.
Jab, jab, right hand.
To a noisy York Hall, who are seeing a good start to this light welterweight fight.
Decent right hand from Lenny Daws. He started to find his timing, started to find the accuracy, and the engine is starting to run now.
23rd fight for Lenny Daws. He's only ever been beaten once. That was for Barry Morrison. He was a little bit below par that night at Alexandra Palace. He wrote the wrongs in this very ring. Stopping Morrison in 10 last time out. What now? Jason Cook. Good first couple of rounds. Landed that left hook. And again to the body. But he's only, before this fight, completed 8 rounds since 2005, and that could be tough as this, well, gets harder.
But he will be fresher because of that gap. You know, that's why he's looking sharp. He's obviously trained well. But Lenny Daws starting to get the centre of the ring, starting to look to push Cook back. Take the play away.
And that body shot and whipping the uppercut through again, Jason Cook. Steady from Daws. He obviously thinks there's a lack of head movement from Daws, Cook, the way he's bringing the uppercut into play.
Yeah, he's a little bit upright, isn't he? Quite stiff upper body around the shoulders and the neck. Daws.
He's been a good solid performer though, Daws, at this level. There's some speed from him this time, the champion. And a battle of the jabs.
He's got the height and the reach. He's got to use that.
Left hook to the top of the head from Cook. Trying to outbox Daws here, and a right hand. This hand speed is the big shot from Jason Cook tonight. Capitalised on that good third, Daws, has he?
No, it's been steadier in this round, but Cook hasn't done a great deal. A few decent shots. In a closer one.
Nice right from Cook. And a left hand. He's beating Daws to the punch in some of these exchanges.
It's nice movement around the ring from Cook as well. Moves the head, steps around, gives some angles, and then comes back.
Really interesting.
10 weeks. Back to that jab straight away. When you're rolling down here, spin off.
Kezakwit says he owes Darren Wilson everything in this comeback, his trainer.
Showing the speed there, just flicking that right hand over from long range, catching Daws on the chin.
So the punch has landed. Cook in the ascendancy by 15. And many more body shots as well. That might be something that Daws would try to slow Cook down, maybe over these middle rounds. It's the 156th as a professional for Lenny Daws, who began in 2003. And the 136th, that's all, for Jason Cook, who started in 1996.
Great hand from Daws. Beating Daws to the jab, that's not good for Daws.
Cook was telling us in the build-up, people forget my boxing skills, I was an ABA champion. I got silver in the Commonwealth Games, they just think I can punch with that left hook.
That's true, because he has got such a devastating punch when it lands. You forget that, you know, what he's showing now, he has got good boxing skills. Caught with a jab on the way in there.
Lost his European title at 9 stone 9 on the scales, couldn't make the weight. It was a real struggle in the end for Jason Cook, who gave us some good nights in Maesteg. Lenny Daws has been giving us good nights in London. Nice shot from him. Not just good, honest domestic fare, this, Glenn. There's plenty of skills, too.
Oh, this is good to watch. Good excitement. And you know there's some drama to come.
Respect that.
Doing better in this round, Daws. Just a solid look about him, but Cook, nice little uppercut.
Walked into that Daws, but his movement has been better in the fifth. Utilising the ring, but there's the big hook again. Cook's confident tonight. It's as if he really, really believes he can win this fight.
Yep.
Amazing comeback story if Jason Cook can pull this off. Blood to the nose, though, and an uppercut from Daws at the end of that.
Big fight weekend ahead on Saturday Night Live from Wembley Arena, right here on Sky Sports HD1. Nathan Cleverley challenges Italy's Antonio Brancaleone for the vacant European light heavyweight title. It all starts at 8 o'clock. It's also available in standard definition on Sky Sports 1.
Yeah, important year for Nathan Cleverley, aiming to graduate from Cardiff University with a maths degree as well in the summer. The unbeaten Welshman. Compatriot Jason Cook here, looking to roll back the years and take the British title that he's always craved. The names of his beloved children on his shorts, Reese, Chloe, Ellie and Ali Aya. He says it's all for them. Nearly 35 Cook. Daws having just turned 31. Big pre-fight favourite, Lenny Daws. What are you thinking now, Glenn?
Well, it's still pretty close. I've got Cook just ahead. Daws landing some good shots in the last round, and he started looking good here, landing inside with nice hurtful uppercuts.
And all the time trying to detonate that left hook, disguise it, so Daws doesn't see it coming. Still got the centre of the ring, Lenny Daws. And this is the time in a Daws fight where he begins to really steamroll through.
Yeah, picks up the pace, doesn't he? It's hard to live with him with that pace.
On his last five doors as well. Much busier than Cook, who failed at the semi-final hurdle and prize fighter to the eventual winner, Gavin Rees, was floored and had to take a punch there. Good from Daws.
Tries for the left hook, but Daws again. Timing that guard, getting the hand in the right place.
Good jabs though from Cook. Still got the legs at nearly 35. Combination from Cook, not all landing, but flashy.
Picking some decent punches, isn't he?
He's not really letting Daws win two or three in succession, get into a rhythm. That's what he's not doing. Good work from Cook. I think he'll be very pleased at the halfway stage.
Good finish in the round, then. Right, sit back. Sit back. Sit right away back.
Deep again.
When you're inside, Jace, you keep it your chin's high, and you're coming out, you're not doing anything, he's catching it.
Okay, okay.
Cook's still got the speed, got the time. See how nice, sharp, but relaxed the way he throws that jab out. And then finishing off the round, nice combination. Daws, some good work early on in the round. The left two landing well.
Cook throwing more, landing more, better success. Probably in front. But a long way to go. And we could be entering more of Lenny Daws' type of territory as he defends this British title for the first time, second time around in his career. The gold and black of Daws, and the odds back in favour of the champion, as they were at the beginning. Is that strange?
Yeah, I've still got Cook ahead. It's going one way, then the other. But Cook still looks dangerous, still working well.
What have the bookies seen? Do they think Cook will slow down now? Marking around the right eye for Jason Cook, who's only ever lost three fights through his career, also held the IBO title, lightly regarded, but had a good run with it. Just frustrated there, Daws.
Daws trying to push forward with the straight punches.
How much in the Cook tank? I mean, he can train very, very hard for a long time, but what about actually fighting the rounds in the ring, Glenn? How difficult is that, energy-wise?
Well, you know, he's had plenty rounds in the past. He had a few years off. He needed that. His body needed that. He's come back with a lease of life, and it looks that way. But whether he can sustain it over the 12 rounds.
Good inside work from Lenny Daws.
Slightly getting a little more ragged, Jason Cook. Daws just keeping it together
a little better.
Oh, good work from Daws. A better round. Maybe the bookies are right. Cook just frustrated. Hands down. There's a change here.
See, that's what happens when a fighter loses concentration. Yeah, just lost the game plan for the moment, Jason Cook. And that's because Daws is doing it right. Daws is starting to get to him now.
Methodical, sensible, steady from Daws. Less noticeably from Jason Cook.
Relax, this is where the second wind comes in. Now, this is where all the hard training comes in, right? Deep breaths. Train too hard for this. This is US.
He's tired, man. He'll start to have a swing and then he's going to die. All you've got to do is be professional with him. Do you understand me? Len, I'm telling you, be professional. Keep the shots flowing. Block him moving, all right? Don't force it, okay? And you break him down, I'm telling you. All right? Don't get rushing in when you catch him with someone, all right? Right glove eye for this left hook here. Start getting desperate, all right? Listen, one, two up. Moving the feet. Come on, mate.
Good trainer, isn't he? Robert McCracken. He was a good fighter. And he's knowledgeable and intelligent.
Yeah, speaks an awful lot of sense in there.
Calling for the second wind. The Jason Cook corner. The Welsh colours. At the 34-year-old from Maesteg, the gold and black, as usual, of Lenny Daws, who doesn't want to let down these fans in London. Doesn't want to lose the British title. He's lost it once before. Wants to keep hold of it and hopefully move up in levels.
But it was noticeable. He was feeling it a little bit in the last round, Cook, and started to make mistakes.
Well, this is what Daws is so good at, Glenn. I mean, against Barry Morrison, he had early trouble, but he felt Morrison tiring in there.
Yeah, he keeps it together, you know. He is very professional. He does a good, solid job. And, you know, that's what a lot of younger fighters have got to look at. He keeps the hands nice and high. He works the jab. He does it correctly.
Overcome problems in the ring early on with knockdowns and cuts and trouble. He's got through those bumps, Lenny Daws. Just a bit of tape. A little loose on the right glove, though Parra says carry on. And then Jason Cook nearly falls over him.
His hands starting to come down. Then maybe to feel the pace, the lack of rounds over the last few years could be a factor.
I'm trying to spare out the jab, but there's much more coming from Daws now. It's sporadic, these attacks from Cook. His victories by knockout, Jason Cook. Hasn't managed to hurt Daws though since that opening round.
And normally that's the worst time to get hurt early in the fight, but he took it well. He saw the effect it had on Sandro Casamonica when Jason Cook won the European title.
Yeah, you can catch fighters cold, can't you? But you sort of become accustomed.
Yeah, you're used to it in sparring. Your body starts to adjust. You start to just tighten your neck muscles and tighten your jaw. And, you know, you get the timing of the punch as the fight goes on.
Yeah, it's all Daws now.
Okay, Yeah. Just got to be sharper, Len. You're just forcing it a little bit. Listen, listen, move the feet. Move the feet before you
very good
punch,
division.
Okay?
The past champions, Dave Boyd Green, of course, went on to fight Carlos Palomino, Sugar Ray Leonard for world title shots. Clinton McKenzie, the famous South London fighting family. I think his son's about to turn professional as well. Another dynasty. Terry Marsh, undefeated IBF world champion. Use this as a good stepping stone. Pat Barrett, excellent puncher. Just fell short at world level. Andy Holligan, wasn't he fun? Two-time British champion. Lost to Julio Cesar Chavez, the great. Ricky Hatton, our very own. Went on to become a two-weight world champion, of course, and Junior Witter. Very good fighter, former WBC champion as well. An illustrious list. And Lenny Daws, at the moment, might be holding on to that British light welterweight title. Probably close, though, Glenn.
Yeah, it is close on, Michael. I've got a dead level with Lenny Daws now coming back in. It's a good start from Jason Cook, but just starting to look tired. 76-76. All left in the all of the last four rounds.
I've got Daws in front. I think he's really turned it around in the last few. And Cook attempting the body attacks. Very realistic, Jason Cook. Knows it's a hard ask, this. But he's giving it a real go. He's not letting his fans down. Daws getting closer. More accuracy. More control now.
Yep, the hands are coming down, getting ragged, the work, losing the discipline of his style and getting caught more and more. When you get tired, the hands come down, the defense gets sloppy, and that's what's happening to Cook. And it looks like Daws just starting to break him down.
Getting that jab going. Having listened to Robert McCracken, keep it professional. Only eight knockouts on the Daws slate, but he does punch sharply, crisply, and it's the work rate of Daws. Throws so many punches. Damage under the right eye of Cook.
I think Jason Cook, I think he's only got one stoppage after the sixth round point in his career. The power starts to diminish as the rounds go on.
Right hands. Brave, gallant from Cook. Trying to live with him. But this pace. He somehow keeps himself fresh, doesn't he, Lenny Daws, for the latter stages?
Yep, he just, you know, his body's obviously conditioned well, and you know, he gets in a rhythm when fighters start to tire, that's when he starts to come into his own.
Good sparring sessions he's had with Lee Purdy and Peter McDonough, who fights Frankie Gavin on the Wembley bill this weekend.
To sit on him now and outwork him and break him down, all right? This is your part now, these three rounds is your fight, all right? Deep breath, come on. Okay?
Lenny,
chin
really
on
tight.
Your chest,
come
side
on,
to side, and then back him up. And now let's work him, let's press him, okay?
Daws looking better. Starting just to get more and more punches landing. And looking a little bit in disarray at times, Jason Cook. As Daws keeps his concentration intact.
Deep breaths, deep breaths. The auction back in.
So much good round
there. Big, big 10 from there, right?
Yeah. Straight shot for that left uppercut. Boom, 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 boom.
Are they beginning just to lose a bit of belief? That tight-knit corner from Wales. Jason Cook tries to dart out, but Lenny Daws grabs the middle of the ring again, pumping the jab through. Only Barry Morrison, having beaten Daws on that split, got a win and a draw over Nigel Wright, which looks excellent after Wright's recent victory over Alex Arthur. And this belt has been on a bit of a merry-go-round, hasn't it? Fighters aren't holding on to the British light welterweight title, and Daws wants to now.
He just needs a win here and one more to get the Lonsdale belt.
Being out jab now, Cook. Those fast flurries that we saw early on, not in evidence anymore. And a right hand there from Daws. Gum shield is out. Just took his mind off the job, and a few deep breaths in the neutral corner from Jason Cook. Are we creeping towards maybe Cook needing a knockout?
I think if he gets another round in the bag, Daws, it's gonna be that sort of panic stations from Cook. But when he panics, he gets wild, and when he gets wild, he gets hit.
We don't know how the three judges are seeing things. Could be close. Daws could be in a handy lead, we don't know. But it's certainly in charge of the fight now. Good left hook, and Jason Cook just shakes his head. He did that when he was floored by Gavin Rees in Prize Fighter, as if to say, I wouldn't have been hit like that years ago.
Yeah, some good little work on the inside from Lenny Daws. Using the free hands, not looking to hold. And this is good from Daws
right
now.
From Daws. Just fell backwards there, Jason Cook. This is where he caught up with Barry Morrison. It's becoming tough. A hard grind for Cook just to keep with Daws. Lenny, shout the Morden Massive, who have crowded this York Hall and made it a really good atmosphere. Their man. Plenty ahead on Friday Fight Night tonight. And we stay in the 10-stone division. English belt on the line. Steve Williams, Michael Grant, great clash of styles. Don't miss that one. Excellent 10-stone boys.
And you've got to come off that jab. You want to do it.
Okay.
Everything comes off that jab.
Pulling ahead now, Lenny Daws. Good pressure. Looking strong, pushing Jason Cook back. He's the boss in there now. He's part of the fight.
Press him, let's press him. Let's put it on him. Let's run him out of there. Right? Come on, switch done. Come on. Don't blow. Don't blow. Serve
is out. Round 11.
Lenny Daws unbeaten in his last seven fights. He had a rocky start, as often he tends to do. Very bright early, Jason Cook. But it's all beginning to catch up with him.
Yeah, pulling ahead now. Last four rounds for me. It's all been Daws. Good work.
I've got Daws by three. 6 minutes to go. But remember, has the power. But can he detonate late on? Is there enough energy even left?
To double up the left hooks inside, still looking strong and fresh, Lenny Daws.
That's good from Cook. Riposte with the jab. And really shows that left hook. I think even if he goes home without the belt tonight, which may look on the cards now, Jason Cook. He's sort of proved a point to himself, hasn't he?
Yeah, done terrifically well, hasn't he, to come back and, you know, get himself into contention. And just doing that has been pretty, pretty good.
He's had his personal problems, and it's given him a new lease of life. But Daws, this is impressive. He just doesn't panic, does he?
No. And, you know, Jason Cook's showing that, you know, he's hardly had any rounds at all. There's still a few more fights in him.
Another good clash for a British title. That Lonsdale bout, they want it, the fighters. Not had to do much, Dave Paris, which is always good to see. But now Daws looks the puncher. Combinations, Cook easier to hit. Beginning to joke around a little bit in there, Jason Cook, as if he knows that it's slipping away.
Yeah, but Lenny Daws doing it the professional way, keeping himself together.
Good body shot from Cook. Still occasionally, but here comes Daws. Wide open Cook. Shakes his head in defiance. Has been stopped before. Will he be again?
Good man. Good man.
Deep breath. Got nothing left.
Get a breath. Deep legs out.
Deep
breath.
Got nothing left now.
Listen, keep them flowing. Don't load up. Keep them flowing. Short and sharp with them left and right now.
And short uppercuts and ups.
I don't want you swinging, all right? Yeah. He'll have a little...
Don't come back, Jason. Keep your hands tight. And when you're busy, you're busy, right? Busy. Come on, don't leave anything in that tank, Jason. I don't want anything left
in it.
Okay, 100 odd punches.
Stay focused. Because you'll wing a couple of big ones over. So straight to him, keep him off balance and you in control. And keep him throwing. Come on.
And that's what he's done so well.
And don't
switch off. Jason Cook off balance in the second half of this fight. Cook trying to rally his supporters. He's enjoyed it, which is great to see. He's a student of the game, Jason Cook. He must know he needs a knockout.
Yeah, great to see two guys after such a tremendous fight give each other a hug before they go in the last round. But he's pulling ahead, Lenny Daws. Jason Cook has to find one of those blistering left hooks.
Some of those early rounds close. Mark Green, Terry O'Connor and Victor Lochman in front of us, the three judges. But Daws, well, for both of us in the driving seat. I've got a little bit wider than you, I think, Glenn. Is there a last big left hook?
I don't think so. You know, I think he's smiling like he knows his fate, that he knows he can't do it. He's done well, Jason Cook, but you just feel the boss in there, the man who's done the more and who looks like the champion is Lenny Daws.
Fight of two halves. A bit like the British Super Bantamweight title last week. Good operators. And I wonder if it would have been different a few years ago if it had been the Jason Cook at 26-27 against the Daws maybe of now.
Well, you must be thinking of Cook, those years that he was out, what could he have done?
Oh, he looks in trouble now. One or two of these may be low. Good body shot though, as well went in there, and a game from Daws and Cook. Running on empty, last minute. There's almost nothing left. He's given it everything.
And I think, Glenn, if there was another round or two, he might not make it. But does he deserve to hear the final bell?
Yeah, he certainly does. But whether he's going to or not, I'm not sure. Daws looks intent on the stoppage. He's not going to stop throwing punches. This has been an excellent fight right to the very
end. Good action, competitive, and honestly fought. He has no strength left in his legs at all. He'll be flopping his way to the final bell. There's respect from Daws, and then he just tries to drive home the punches.
That's the way he fights, right to the end. Getting stronger and stronger and stronger as this fight's going on.
Another solid 12-round championship performance from Lenny Daws, who deserves to retain his belt in London tonight. Jason Cook, plenty of credit for him. He gave his all in what was a, well, an enthralling British title fight in many ways. Plenty of action for the fans, thoroughly enjoyable, and a hug between the two. And Cook knows as well, doesn't he?
Yeah, you can tell just by the body language. Daws, a lot more punches, landed more as well, better success rate.
Great start though, wasn't it, from Jason Cook?
An excellent start. He really turned back the clock, didn't he, Jason Cook? Come out the blocks well, landed and hurt Daws in the first round. It looked like we might be getting a shock on our hands early on. It kind of went one way and then the other. But Cook did look good for the first four or five rounds. But it was the halfway point when Lenny Daws started to do things, started to get his work going. Cook always competitive, always looking for a good counterpunch. But Daws, professional, workmanlike, kept the punches going in. And as the rounds went on, the later rounds were more and more. Daws getting his own way, starting to push Cook about. And Cook just starting to fall apart and feel the effects of this tough 12-rounder. Body shots going in and Cook looking hurt. And Daws, for me, landing out a good winner.
Decent match on paper, and it lived up to it in reality. Glenn thinks by 4 to Daws. Let's find out officially.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dave Parris would like you to join in one more time in congratulating both boxers. That was a sensational championship bout of 12 rounds. Ladies and gentlemen, Judge Victor Lachlan scores the contest 115-114 in favour of Cook. Judge Terry O'Connor scores the contest 115-114 in favour of Daws. Judge Mark Green scores the contest 114-114. We have a draw. Your winner, and still the British Light-Welterweight champion from Melbourne, the Lightning, Lenny Daws.
Well, it's all subjective. Three very close cards. Lenny Daws keeps his British title on the draw, a wonderful duel. But I bet he'll be a little bit sad that he didn't win that, Daws.